As a graduate student, I was introduced to a cortical structure called the hippocampus, which mammals use as a navigational system, as well as a system that is used to lay down short-term memories. One of the prices that mammals pay for having this hippocampus is that it's also prone to neural circuit disorders such as epilepsy, and is often damaged during stroke and is now implicated in disorders like Alzheimer's. Many of these disorders take center stage inside the hippocampus or other parts of the cortex, and they're typically involving changes in the way that cells communicate with each other. So my lab is primarily interested in cell excitability. And cell excitability is really how cells communicate with each other using electrical events. Like much of the power that we have coming out of our wall, cells use a million-fold less of these voltages or currents to trigger events that will allow communication across a circuit. What we do is we can study these small circuits and understand how they can be changed by different types of activities or different types of events. The rewards of this research are twofold. The first is it allows us a greater understanding of how the human brain actually works, how cells communicate with each other, and how circuits are established and built. The second is that we can take this basic understanding of the brain and use it for the future treatment of neural circuit disorders. So the potential for this kind of research in helping us understand the conditions such as schizophrenia and Parkinson's and Alzheimer's is tremendous. The Brain Initiative is going to revolutionize how we do neurosciences. One of the main goals of neurosciences is to view in real time or in living tissue how cells are communicating with each other. So understanding how what cells are involved and how those cells are communicating with each other is going to be really rapidly advanced with the emergence of new technologies that are supported by the Brain Initiative. One of the great things about doing neuroscience at the NIH is that you have access to many people across many different institutes. In fact, the strength of the Porter Neuroscience Building is that it's home to individuals from over a dozen institutes. The luxury that you have of being in the Porter Neuroscience community is that you have a greater access to all sorts of people from all sorts of walks of neurosciences. We share equipment, we share lab space, intellectually we share ideas, and the walls between institutes have really been eliminated. In my view, this is probably the premier venue for doing neurosciences, and it's great to be a part of the Porter Neuroscience community. It's a very rich time in the neurosciences, and I think the next decade is going to be a tremendous time.